Can you share a little more ideas on how these crystals can be used? Because, you know, you just mentioned there are seven chakras are there and there are different varieties of crystals are there. So do we have specific crystals for specific chakras and how can we use it at our home and at our office? Can you just give a little more idea on that?
Yes. So crystals, they come in different colors and different forms. Yes. So depending on our chakras have seven colors, right? The Vibhyor.
Yes.
So the crystals do have that Vibhyor color and it depends on which chakra it works on.
Okay.
So for example, the root chakra, which is the Muladhara chakra, it is red color, right?
Yes.
All the red crystals and black crystals come under this.
Okay.
And this color combination works.
Okay.
Just as sound healing works, sound vibrations work, the mantras work on the body, on the energy field. And the color has good vibrations and good frequencies, they match with the frequencies of the energy field and they work accordingly. That is how crystals work in our body.
Okay.
And when it comes to home, there are several issues. Like we face a lot of issues at home, like there is no positivity at home, lot of quarreling happening at home always. People are not calm. Kids are not good at studies, and there's always some negativity at home. Some evil eye problem, this problem, that problem, and all.
Okay.
We always have all these issues. The relationship issues is like one major thing we face these days.
Correct.
Between kids, between father, like spouse, and all these things. So placing crystals, seven chakra crystals at home, it energizes the place, the entire home, and energizes everyone around.
Wow. Okay. Where do you keep this? When you say energizes the home, where should I keep these crystals?
You can keep it in a place where everybody is like moves around. Something like a hall, living room where everybody comes in. Not in a bedroom. Because
okay.
Only a few people use that.
Okay.
So, hall is one place where everybody, like we say, we need dining hall, we can keep where everything is energized. Everyone will be energized. And even it works as Vastu crystals. The seven chakra crystals are also good for Vastu issues. Any Vastu issues are sorted by this chakras.
Okay. So I've seen these crystals. We also, recently I used these crystals also, and I created a brand Palaham Seven Crystal Healings. Now I've seen these are small stones. Okay. So when you say keep it on the hall, how do I keep it? Just openly keep it, or you keep it in the box, or how do?
Yes, you need to keep it open. Because the energies of the crystals should reach the people around.
Okay.
Yes, it shouldn't be closed. If you close the crystals, if you keep it in a closed container or if you close the box, it will not work for you.
Okay.
The energies will not come out.
Okay. In my home, I have just kept it in a glass bowl and I put all. Is that okay? Is that a good way to?
Yes, very good.
Okay. So some of the people have asked me, should I keep it in my puja room and all? So will you suggest? Or?
Yes, it is very, very good. Very good to keep it in the puja room because it will get energized. The crystals will get more energized. As I said, they are sages.
Ah, okay. That's interesting.
They'll get more energized. We can show incense sticks on the crystals.
Oh, you can do incense sticks and aarti and all
that. Yes, everything.
So you can do puja to the crystals also.
Yes.
Wow, interesting. So, but
you can treat them as God.
Okay, so what I understand is these crystals are like sages and they emit certain vibrations and frequency, and if it's kept in the hall or in the puja room, it emits the radiation and frequency, thereby it heals everyone around and solves many different varieties of challenges.
It will not allow any negatives to come.
Oh, it will not allow any negative energy also to come in. Wow, that's a big benefit of these crystals. Wow, thank you. I'm going to now tell my mom how to use this now. Thank you.